I put him to bed around 10:30. I fell asleep just like he always did. And I woke up in the morning to a lifeless Jameson.
We lost our little boy on July 3rd. And since then, nothing's been the same.
You can't describe the pain of losing a son or a daughter. I'll never forget the day. Well, the next morning, Gabby was having some thoughts that every normal parent would. She wanted to be with her son. She didn't want to be here. She wasn't suicidal. She just didn't want to be here. She was brought down to a local hospital that she was, you could say, locked up.
Suicide
watch in a empty white room. Nothing to look at, nothing to keep her mind off of what had just happened the day before, burying her son.
And that alone was enough. But then to be taken away from my family, from the one other person that knew what I was going through, it was too much. And I don't want anyone else to have to go through that, to feel the way that I did, to feel so empty and so lost and scared and alone.
She needed a tranquil place, not a place that she wasn't going to get help. As low as we both were in life at that time, and still are, I'm proud of Gabby for thinking of something that, a place that she wanted to be at, a place that any grieving parent would want to be at. Some place where parents could feel that they were welcome.
It would be very much patient-centered on what they need, because nobody grieves the same.
And Gabby, being a nurse herself, a registered nurse, she knows the compassion that needs to go into a facility like the Jameson House. There's no other house in the area that would provide the care and the comfort and the stability that people need after they lose a child. Because the last thing in this world that we would wish on anybody is to lose a child and have to bury a child.
Yeah.